Hi, I'm Aryé Elfenbein. I'm one of the co-founders of Wildtype. I think like many of us here at Wildtype, none of us would have imagined that this would have turned into a career of growing seafood outside of the animal. Having a process that doesn't rely on harvesting from the oceans in unsustainable ways is one that gives our planet a chance to heal in many ways from a lot of the destructive practices that we've seen previously. There's an interesting article that came out about 2 to 3 years ago quantifying the carbon footprint of commercial fishing operations, and in particular, deep sea trawling, which essentially is dragging these city-sized nets across the bottom of the ocean. It was calculated that the carbon footprint of that is actually greater than all of the airplanes in the world combined. And this is a lot of what the impetus was to create farmed fishing operations. They really have taken some of the pressure off the oceans. But there's still very much a reliance on the oceans to provide the food for the fish farms. And even with fish farming operations, as waters have started to warm, the same coastal sites have become unusable. Typically about 40 to 50% is discarded because there are parts that aren't consumed by humans, such as fins and internal organs and so forth. So we wanted to create a system where we were able to produce only what we consume. Cultivated seafood is growing the same cuts of seafood we know and love outside of the animal. To be able to produce seafood free of heavy metals, antibiotics, parasites, and other agents that are common in seafood is a unique, healthful aspect of what we create. The process begins with a single cell. In our case, that cell came from a small salmon about 5 years ago. We haven't had a need to go back to the animal since then. By understanding all of the nutrients that cells ordinarily receive as they were growing naturally inside of the animal, fats, proteins, and the amino acids for them to create new proteins. We also then provide a structure for them to grow within using common plant-based ingredients. The cells grow in a very similar way to the way that yeast grew for the beer brewing process. The building that we're in most recently was our beloved neighborhood beer brewery. Probably the greatest misconception is that this is lab grown. Actually, none of what we produce is produced in a lab.
I've been plant-based for 3 years, so this will be my first time having salmon in a very long time.
It's super exciting.
I didn't know what to expect. It's much better than I expected. I'm having a hard time finding any difference.
Texture and appearance are the closest things. I think for me, the flavor is very mild, very clean fish flavor. I have been a sushi chef for the last 12 years. I joined Wildtype because I thought this was the most exciting thing. We have another option that has no waste, and it's clean, and it's cruelty-free. As soon as we get the go from the FDA, hopefully soon, consumers will be able to order these at a restaurant nearby their places.
To create just 1% of all of the seafood that's produced in the world in a year, just 1%, we'd need all of the steel tanks in the world. This field is one that's truly in its infancy today. There have been estimates that wild Atlantic salmon is unfortunately on track to become extinct by the year 2050 with current fishing practices. From here in San Francisco up to Alaska is actually salmon country, and in all of the little streams and brooks around here, there used to be quite a lot of salmon coming back every year, where now in most places there are almost none. It's always heartening to see allies in places where you wouldn't imagine. And one example of that are the fishermen, fisherwomen who we've met who actually believe that this is a chance to have more fish return to their communities. We need fish farms to succeed and to become more sustainable and to become of higher standards. We need wild fishing to also represent true stewards of the ocean and to be doing that in a responsible way. We need the plant-based sector to also have products that really delight customers. And I think that cultivated seafood is part of that. It's not one over another that is important here. I actually think that all of the different approaches need to work together.